Okay, so I'm ready to tie the bungee on. Now, I bought this bungee at my local hardware store. This is 3/16, and I think I paid 25 cents a foot for it. So it wasn't much, and I just have my propane torch here just so I can burn these ends real quick. I never have a lighter handy. So let me show you what we got going on here. First thing you want to do is you want to tie a really good square knot in the end of the boot. And all these boots is real convenient that they all have this little collar at the end. So, you know, you can tie it real tight and it's not going to slip off. So let's do that first. So, and this I just do a basic square knot. And a basic square knot is just so simple. It's just right over left, left over right, whichever way you want to do it. So however you can remember to do it. So here I'm gonna start this off here, and I'm just gonna go. I may have to cut these because when I did the other ones, I got in a groove and I was able to really do a good job on it. But this one that actually looks not too bad right there. So I'm gonna just do this right here. So I'm gonna do this one right over left. And then I'm going to go left over right. I'm going to get this tight right now. Left over right. So there's just your basic square knot right there. And the next thing I want to do is I want to tie a figure eight in the end of this right here, somewhere right in here. And I want to leave a tail on this, a good tail. Well, I forgot to burn that one. Let me do that one right now while I'm at it. Well, I like to leave a pretty nice tail, about 2 inches, to be able to pull it, have something to pull on to get to make this connection. But here, what I want to do here is tie a figure eight. And it's not that critical that I get this exactly right, because I'm going to be able to adjust where this goes here now. But a figure eight is going to be a chunkier knot, and it's a real easy knot. So you just go like, so you just go back around the standing part, and then right back down through the hole again. Real easy. So there's your figure eight right there. So it's a nice chunky knot that will be good. See, I got this one a little bit too short, but it'll be all right. I'm gonna make it work. So, you know, that's gonna be what's gonna grab on inside the hook. Okay, so now let's thread the hook through. And determine where this is gonna need to be. So let me go ahead and get my cord coiled up and kind of get a feel. And these don't have to be tight. You barely have to put any pressure. So each one's going to be different when you make these, because American tools have short cords. They generally have 9 foot long cords, 8 and 9 foot long cords. European tools have 12 and 15. So they're long foot long cords. They're much more generous with their copper. So here's my over-under. Okay, so let's see what I got going on here. So, like I said, it doesn't have to be tight. All it has to be is just enough tension to, you know, to hold it. And it's not going to jump out. So let me put a little mark on this right here where the knot should be. And again, I'm going to do a figure eight here too.
messed that one up. Let me scooch it up before I tighten it down. Once you tighten this bungee down, it's real hard to get it. But if you don't tighten it down, it's easy to move the knot up. Here, like that. Yeah, it wasn't very hard to get undone. Just a pair of needle nose was all it took. Now that's perfect, right there. Third time is the charm. Just the right amount of tension, not too sloppy. I have just a little bit of tension on the elastic. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut this guy and burn it. It can be cut a little shorter. Okay, that's done. And whenever I'm done with the propane torch, I'm always in the habit, I just take the snout off. I never leave it on. For one thing, I'll knock it over and bust the torch part, but I just think it's a bad idea to leave it hooked up in case you walk off and leave it with it running. Okay, so that's done. And a couple tries to get that knot in the right position. There you have it. And this is something I could never do before until I figured this out, was put a whole bunch of tools in a drawer and not have the cords all fouled up. Either not have the cords wrapped around the tool, damaging the cord and kinking the cord, or if I put them in a drawer, then I'd have the cords all fouled up if the cords were just loose. So this has really solved a huge problem for me and cost me practically nothing. You know, I had some UHMW, I had to buy few dollars worth of bungee cord, and I had drill bits and a marker and table saw, and so it was easy to make. And this has been a really good thing for me.